Bergedorf in Germany. Boy, they did it with the pressure on.
He's looking for the zone. Is he in it?
Oh,
quad toe, triple toe.
Too good. Too good. Unbelievable.
That was awesome.
Experience and the savvy. They've been around for a long time behind Borden Kratz. They call it the City of Champions, Edmonton, Alberta. And tonight, a night of champions, the parade of champions from the BMO Financial Group Canadian Championships. Welcome inside the Rexall Place in Edmonton. As we look back at the 2004 Nationals, I'm Rod Black, alongside Debbie Wilkes and Tracy Wilson. Another Nationals is in the books. And as every year, there are always storylines that weave themselves. There's always the formation of the national team and world team. But this one, unanimously, we all agree, this one was different. This was not your mother's Nationals.
Oh, absolutely not. In fact, in my wildest dreams, I don't think I could have imagined the kind of success that we saw, not just in one or two events and not just with one or two skaters. The quality of the skating was deep and success was rampant.
And what I liked about this competition was there was so much great stuff happening on the ice, and the judging was not a factor, except that it was exceptional throughout the competition. How nice to have a competition of this level without judging controversy. It was quite refreshing.
We had a week full of highlights, and I think we all unanimously also agree on the number one highlight of the week.
Got to be Ben Ferreira.
Tough to pick, though.
Yeah.
I mean, always an exceptional competitor, always the best kind of skills. But when he laid down that quad, oh, my gosh.
Doug Lee, his coach, said around Christmas time, watch out for Ben Ferreira. He's training like an animal. Because of that training, he was on fire in this competition.
And he's going to the World Championships, and it was back in 1994 we saw a great men's battle, hard to believe it was 10 years ago, Curt Browning and Elvis Stoiko. And speaking of Elvis Stoiko, just a few moments ago, he was inducted into Canada's Figure Skating Hall of Fame, where both of you, by the way, have also been inducted. And this was a few moments ago, Elvis Stoiko being honored at center ice here. And best of all today, he's going to skate for us as well. And we'll hear from Elvis. Past champion, today's champions, and the future champions all tonight here in Edmonton on CTV. Here are two young kids we're going to be talking about for years to come. Jessica Dubé, Bryce Davison are Canada's junior champions in pairs. They are also the Grand Prix champions in pairs. They are already world beaters. What a great way to start off our night of champions. A look at future champions.
Skating to their short program from competition. Jessica also finished second in the junior ladies event. What a week she's had.
Thank you.
skating on perfectly clean ice, a blank canvas, and creating shapes of success. Jessica Dubé and Bryce Davison, junior pair champions of Canada.
What a week for the teenage girls of Quebec. Marianne Sampson, junior ladies gold medalist, 15-year-old from Saint-Jean-sur-Richelieu.
How about that? Her first trip to the Canadian Championships. She takes home gold and skates to respect.
And that's what she got, a lot of respect, winning both short and long programs to become the new junior lady champion of Canada, Marianne Sampson.
Good word this week for women's skating in Canada. You're watching the 2004 BMO Financial Group Canadian Championships on CTV.
For the Parade of Champions, we're skating to the original dance that we did this week. And we really like to do it because it gets the crowd going and it gets us excited and it's a lot of fun.
Yeah, it's a great program for shows just because of the blues rock and roll rhythm. It really gets the audience involved.
Potential has been a key word at the Canadian Championships. Some skaters realizing their potential this week and other skaters showing they've got tons of it. That's the truth with this team. Junior dance champions Tessa Virtue, Scott Moyer. 14 and 16 years of age.
Thank you.
How cute was that?
That's a word. They are very cute, but I'll tell you what.
And talented.
They have flashes of huge upside. They'll be Canadian senior champions someday.
Tessa Virtue, Scott Moyer, watch for them.
For the Parade of Champions, I'm going to be skating to This Is the Moment from Jacqueline Hyde. It's a really powerful piece of music that suits me a lot, and I love the lyrics, and it makes me feel like it's my moment.
Performing next at the Parade of Champions is Eric Radford, the junior men's champion of Canada, former novice champion back in 2002. He competed last year in juniors as well. Now he's facing.
Championship from the Toronto Cricket Stadium and Curling Club, Eric Radford.
You're watching the 2004 BMO Financial Group Canadian Championships on CTV. On the ice, Elizabeth Putnam and Sean Wirtz. Second year in a row, they finished third in Canada. Team only together for a couple of years and already doing great things.
May you're still here. I feel you all around me. Your memory's so clear. Deep in the stillness, I can hear you speak. You're still an inspiration. Can it be? I cannot sleep. Here.
Elizabeth Putnam and Sean Words third in Canada, but the talk of the skating world for their stunning look and line. Senior pair bronze medalists at the Nationals.
I'm skating to Teach Me Tiger by Ray Charles and the Pink Martinis, and it's a great, fun-loving piece that I've performed before, but it's such a favorite of mine that I thought I'd bring it back again.
Jennifer Robinson.
The shocker of the week in Edmonton wasn't the fact that Jennifer Robinson relinquished her crown, but she relinquished it to a teenager. 15-year-old turned 16, Cynthia Phaneuf, who you will watch later. Her nickname, Tiger, through the years. The song, Teach Me Tiger.
Teach me, Tiger, how to kiss me. Whoa, 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 whoa. Show me, Tiger, how to kiss me. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Superstar in Canadian skating. She is a six-time champion, but what she has done, what she has been, is a great role model and a very good athlete.
And her nickname, Tiger, comes from the fact that she likes to fight, and because of that spirit, six-time Canadian champion, she's also been a leader in ladies skating in Canada for the youngsters.
For today, for Parade of Champions, we're going to skate on the original dance because we're a new team. We didn't have time really to work on show program, so it's a Hey Pachuco, This Is a Man's World, and
Big Bad Buddha Day.
And our
A new team on the Canadian dance scene, Chantelle Lefebvre with her new partner, Arseny Markov. Bronze medalists in senior dance, and an example of some of the best dancing from around the world coming to Canada.
They can't represent Canada right now because of some citizenship and protocol, but Debbie Wilkes, when that gets all ironed out and they represent Canada, they're going to do great things, I think.
This is a hot couple, great future.
That, only after a year? Imagine what they're going to skate like after two.
You're watching the 2004 BMO Financial Group Canadian Championships on CTV.
For the Parade of Champions, I'm going to be skating to Angels by Robbie Williams. It's actually a program I choreographed myself, and I think I picked this one because it's sort of soothing, and it's been a long week, and I need to just go out there and relax and enjoy it.
Would you please welcome the senior men's bronze medalist, Jeffrey Bubble.
On the ice now, senior men's bronze medalist, Jeffrey Bubble. And oh, what a difference timing makes. He started out the season so well with a big win at the NHK Trophy. Then he suffered food poisoning a few weeks ago at the Grand Prix Final and wasn't able to fully regain his strength until last week. The illness and the lost training time showed in the competition.
Does an angel contemplate my let their wings unfold.
Bronze medalist Jeffrey Bottle wasn't able to show his best in this competition. He will get a chance to do that, though, in a few weeks when he represents Canada at the Four Continents competition.
Our parade of champions will continue after this.
Skates, you know, all the other little fellas down to the rink, they're getting the shin pads, they're getting the goalie mask, but you're holding out for the stretchy pants and the spangly top. You got some kind of unbeatable urge to twirl. I mean, where's that coming from?
Here's the quad toe.
It's indeed an honor for me, Elvis, to be able to pay tribute to you here today. You have given so very much to our sport, our association, our country, and to the world. You will always be in our history, and we hope you will be in our future.
Elvis Stoiko from Richmond Hill, Ontario, from the Toronto Cricket Skating and Curling Club. Elvis is in fourth place. He was sixth in the short program, so we're anxious to see how his free skating will hold up. Good start.
Well, you know, he could make it if he puts in a good performance, does the triples like that triple told him. He could go a long way.
represents the best of what skating is about. The most complete athlete who took every moment deadly serious, but he had that sharp mind, that willingness to compete that has been a role model for much of the skating world.
You mentioned role model, Debbie. His name came up more often than any other skater when you'd ask competitors, who's your idol? Number one on the list almost always, Elvis Stoiko.
And his first skate as a Hall of Famer.
About how it takes an amateur, an eligible skater, several years to fit into the professional world. Not with this guy. He has a sense for the audience, he knows what they want, and he knows how to get them involved in the performance.
He's got still all the tricks.
And he knows where the cameras are, most important.
He knows where the ladies are, too. The guy's a rock star.
Wants to start a singing career, a singing and acting career.
He has been. He is equally a nice guy. One of the great Canadian heroes of this sport. In Canada's Figure Skating Hall of Fame now. What a treat.
Exhibition is your song from Moulin Rouge, sang by Ewan McGregor. And I think it's a piece that the first time we heard it, we just thought it was really powerful, and there's a lot of ups and downs, and it's a very different piece, we find.
Skating next, the two-time Canadian senior pair silver medalists, Annabelle Langlois and Patrice Arquette.
Thank you.
Twice they've come to the Canadian Championships as gold medal favorites, and twice they've taken home the silver medal. Third time lucky?
Well, don't be surprised if they finish in the top five at the Worlds. Their problem is skating at home.
Well, that kind of result is another indication of just how great pair depth is in Canada.
Absolutely.
Annabelle Langlois, Patrice Arquette, they live and train right here in Edmonton.
You're watching the 2004 BMO Financial Group Canadian Championships on CTV.
Please welcome our senior ladies silver medalist, Joanie Rochette.
One of the young stars in Canadian skating, Joanie Rochette, second this year, going to the World Championships, but the top two in Canada, both teenagers. Something that hasn't happened in a long time in this country.
The winner of the ladies' free skate, Joanie, skating to Paint It Black.
Thank you.
Joanie's qualifying free skate was another highlight for me here at Canadians, a true indication that this kind of talent from these young women can fit anywhere on the world podium.
Can she light it up? She's got the goods. Joanie Rochette.
We'll be skating to a song called Quand Tu M'aimes by Charles Aznavour.
Yeah, and in the summertime we went to Sun Valley and had the program choreographed by the popular Lithuanian dance team. And they've sort of challenged us this year in our exhibition number. Normally we just have a little fun and a little bit easy, just rapport with the crowd, but this year it's a little bit difficult, so it should be entertaining as well.
Megan Wing and Eric Moore.
A team that has been to a lot, when I say a lot of national championships. This year they were second. Going to the Worlds again, Megan Wing and Aaron Lowe. Been together almost two decades on the ice in a dance partnership.
Not just great skaters, they have a life away from skating too, both university graduates. Megan Wing and Aaron Lowe, silver medalists in senior dance.
On to the world championships for them again.
For the Parade of Champions, I'm skating to the Black Crowes, Hard to Handle. Very well-known rock and roll tune, a lot of fun. My fiance and I actually choreographed it. We had a lot of fun doing this. So I just want to go out and have some fun today, enjoy myself, and hopefully the audience will as well.
Here is our senior men, silver medal. Ben Ferreira.
10 years ago, he was a novice skater, and the biggest thrill at that time was to skate on Coliseum ice right here. He said it was a big deal. 10 years later, he had the biggest skate of his career. Another big deal. He's going to the World Championships as a silver medalist of Canada. Ben Ferreira on home ice.
Representing Canada at the World Championship, he's going with a quad-triple combination in his arsenal. He can compete with the best in the world.
What a week for him and the skating fans in Edmonton. A great guy, good athlete. Coming up from our Night of Champions.
Fasten your seatbelt.
Yeah, they could be on an airplane to Dortmund, Germany. Boy, they did it with the pressure on.
For the Parade of Champions, we'll be skating to Gary Moore, Still Got the Blues. And it's a piece we put together at the beginning of the season, sort of the end of last season, when we first made our move to Montreal. And we both enjoy skating to it because it's sort of a bluesy piece, and we're really able to get down into our knees and sort of connect with each other, and we enjoy it.
One of the big surprises here in Edmonton this week. Not that they couldn't do it, but not many people had talked about Valerie Marcoux and Craig Bunting. At the end of the week, they're talking about them. Canadian champions.
Every skater, once they start competing at this high level, has to face a lot.
They knew they could do it. They knew they had the material and the technique to carry off the Canadian title, but they didn't know whether they had the mental toughness. And that's why the skaters love this parade of champions. It allows them to relish the moment.
Still ahead on our Night of Champions. She has made a name for herself this week. Unbelievable. Cynthia Phaneuf.
Would you please welcome our ladies champion, Cynthia Phaneuf.
Here's the rookie of the year, Cynthia Phaneuf. Days away from her 16th birthday. She didn't even see it coming.
She's the youngest Canadian women's champion in the senior ranks since 1981, when Tracy Wainman became national senior champion. Nerves, her coach Annie Barabe suggested she wear her practice outfit. She wore it in competition, wore the practice dress again today. That's about to become her lucky dress. Cynthia Phaneuf.
Well, this week she wears gold, her blades, and the medal. The medal here in Edmonton to Cynthia Phaneuf, Canada's new champion. And coming up, well, all that training is paying off. The polish and experience and the savvy, they've been around for a long time behind Borden Kratz.
For the Parade of Champion, we're skating to a bird number.
That was one of Patrice's ideas to make me fly like a bird, so he made up something to put underneath the costume so he can make me fly. So I have great confidence in him because my life is in danger in that number.
And we also had the music composed for us by one of our friends. And she did the music, the voice and everything for us, and a bit of the choreography, so it's very special for us.
Marie-France Debray, masked right now, and Patrice Lauzon, Canada's ice dance champions of 2004. A new era of skating in ice dance in Canada, and they usher it in with a win.
A sign of the influence from their training locale in Lyon, France. Always dramatic, always original, and hoping to crack the top five at the World Championship, Marie-France Debray,
Patrice Lauzon, Canadian ice dance champion.
Still ahead on our Night of Champions.
He's looking for the zone. Is he in it?
Oh, yeah.
Quad toe, triple toe.
Too good. Too good.
Whoa.
Unbelievable.
That was awesome.
Would you please welcome the 2004 FIMO Financial Group Men's Champion, Emmanuel Sandu.
He has been analyzed and criticized for his inconsistency in the past, but this guy is on a roll right now. Emmanuel Sandu coming off a Grand Prix final win over Evgeny Plyshenko in the best in the world, and then a win here when the chips were down, he came through. Canadian champion again.
Interestingly, when he was questioned by the press, one of the questions was, Emmanuel, have you finally found inside your head the key to your inconsistency? He said, hey, you guys have it all wrong. It's not about inconsistency. I finally found how to train.
Well, he's always been an artist. This week, we saw Emmanuel, the athlete.
There is no one in the world who could skate to that piece of music and make it work like Emmanuel Sandu.
And you know what? It was probably made up on the spot. He does this kind of choreography instantaneously in his mind, uses it often as warm-up material.
Says he wants to become a singer, too. You can bet on it. Probably will. What a talented guy. Artist and athlete now. Champion three times of Canada. Already we are looking forward to next season, and the way to kick it off is at Skate Canada. The 2004 MasterCard Skate Canada International will be held in a great skating city. A lot of history there in Halifax. Tickets already available. Call the number on the screen, or you can shop in person at the Metro Center box office in Halifax.
Once again, Emmanuel Sandu.
Emmanuel Sandu getting an encore here. Going from hip-hop and rap music to classical.
Footwork from his short program. Hip-hop, now the tango. Is there anything he can't do?
Music and line just oozes out of this guy. I could watch forever, even if his feet never left the ice.
And this is a guy right now that could knock off the world champion. If he skates like he's capable of, he's finding the way to win.
And the confidence.
Emmanuel Sandu at the Nationals. We'll wrap it up after this. A parade of champions that we haven't quite seen before, because we haven't seen a lot of these skaters before skating in it. New champions, some defending champions who claim their crown again. There's Emmanuel Sandu, and many of these skaters now off to Four Continents Championship and then to the World Championship. Tracy and Debbie, before this week began, there were a lot of people, I think, concerned about Canadian skating. In fact, going to the Worlds, we have a record of 22 years and counting, winning at least one medal. And some people felt, and it could still happen, that Canada might not get a medal at the Worlds. I think there's a lot more confidence now.
Oh, definitely. And I think the last couple of years since Salt Lake City has been a very gloomy, a very dark time in the sport. A lot of people have lost hope. A lot of people have lost their belief in the sport. This was a good week. I think it's changed.
And the world scene is in disarray. You saw what these skaters put out here at the Canadian Championships. Two men in the Canadian Championships landed quads, none in the U.S. Nationals. Few countries on the world scene are producing the kind of depth that Canada is now producing. And this just could be the opportunity for these skaters to step up and get on the world podium, setting themselves up for the next Olympics. The future's looking bright.
It's nobody's dream either. It's not something, it's not wishful thinking. They displayed this week the ability to fit in anywhere in the world order.
Yeah, this Canadian skating is in very good hands right now. And those hands are those young, talented skaters that we're going to be watching in the next few weeks leading up to the World Championships. For Tracy Wilson and Debbie Wilkson, our entire crew here in Edmonton, so long, everyone, from the 2004 Nationals and our Night of Champions in the City of Champions.
This means to me, but here I am, so hard to believe that I'm standing here, that I've come this far. But you always said, have faith in who you are. I wanna take this time to thank you for the love you gave. And from this moment, you'll got to know I never wanted something more, and I never felt so sure. 'Cause now I've got this chance to be everything you saw in me, and even more than I ever dreamed before. As long as you are here with me, I know that I can be something more. Looking back now, it's so clear to me that you were sent to share my destiny. There were times when I was ready to walk away, but you gave me strength to face another day. Yeah, I wanna take this time to thank you for the love you gave. And from this moment, you've got to know I never wanted something more, and I never felt so sure. From this moment, you've got to know I never wanted something more, and I never felt so sure. 'Cause now I've got this chance to be everything you saw in me, and even more than I ever dreamed before. As long as you
thank you very much.